Hi, my name is Gail Sotelo. I am a wine professional. I'm here today to teach you how to open a bottle of wine safely and effectively in the way the pros do it. Every restaurant would have their own standards, but I'm going to teach you the way I was taught. So, this is how we do it. The first thing you have to do is to be able to present the bottle to your guest. So how do you do that? You are supposed to lift up the bottle, make the label show the guest, and say, it's for this particular example, this is a Genesis Gran Reserva Cabernet Sauvignon. You're not supposed to be looking at the label while you're doing that. You're supposed to introduce it like it's your friend. And then you set it down gently. Now, from this point, you will notice that there are many different types of wine openers that are available in the market. Typically for a house, this is what you would find. This is a rabbit opener, right? The other thing that you could potentially find in the house is one of those electric gadgets that you can be able to use to open up the bottle of wine. I am old school and I've been in F&B for quite a number of years, so I try to be old school and use a waiter's friend, okay? First, you are supposed to open it up. You are supposed to find the blade, right? And that is the thing that will allow you to cut from the bottom of the lip. Some people cut it from here, but professional standards kind of want to make you cut it from this point, right? Hopefully this works. Okay, there we go. Okay, and then from the other side. Right. So the important thing that you have to take into consideration is that the bottle didn't move. It's my hands that are moving. And make sure that you are doing it in one motion forward and one motion backwards. So that is the professional way. As much as possible, lift the entire foil up in one motion, put it in your pocket, right? As well as the opener for the first. You're supposed to remember to always have a waiter's cloth on you at all times. Makes you look more professional and it keeps everything sanitary. Now, the thing is, it kind of does look funny, but what you're supposed to do is to be able to wipe the neck of the bottle, right, from this point. Some people kind of wonder why you need to do that. There are many studies that do tell you different things, but the most important thing or the most relevant research that we've had is once upon a time, the foil kind of had a little bit of a lead content to it, and this is what once upon a time kept it safe for consumption. You're supposed to have the corkscrew right here, okay? And for the first time people who are going to do this, what you need to do is to be able to make sure that the coil, the pointy bit of the coil, is to the center of the cork. I can show it a little bit so you can see it, right? If this is your first time to do it, I kind of tell people to cheat it. Don't go immediately upwards, right? Because what that does is you can potentially miss the mark, right? If this is your first time, you can be able to do it from the side and upwards, making sure that the coil is to the center. Apply a little bit of pressure on your dominant hand. I am a right-handed person, so this is what I'm going to be using. Apply a little bit of pressure, let it go. Of course, smile while you're doing it because you don't want to look like you're having a hard time or don't want to make it obvious that you're having a hard time, right? And then typically the waiter's friends have a little bit of a notch over here, right? That's the thing that you use to be able to have support from the mouth of the bottle. Okay, hold on to it with your non-dominant hand, making sure that it doesn't slip because that can potentially cause injuries. Try to lift it up. Right, slowly and surely. Some people think that the better way to go about this is to allow a little bit of a popping sound. It's not the case. It's not the way the professionals do it. There are some cases like this when the cork is a little high, so you can cheat it a little bit by wiggling it. Right? So there, just make sure that it doesn't break. And if you notice, there's no sound, right? That's how you do it, right? Cork is off, take off the cork. Some people would prefer to smell the cork, and in professional standards, you're supposed to hand it over to your guest. But what does a cork really tell you? It just tells you whether or not the wine has been spoiled. What you do next is to be able to wipe again the neck of the bottle. Once again, just to be able to eliminate further the debris, right? And then pour it to your guest, assuming that the guest is you. Make sure that the label is facing the guest. Pour it a bit. Lift it a twist so it doesn't spill. And then afterwards, set it down. Allow your guests to enjoy the wine. Ladies and gentlemen, that's how you open a wine safely and effectively and professionally. Assuming that you haven't finished the bottle of wine, you can employ different stoppers. There are many cute accessories that are available in the market, such as this golden bunny. You can be able to seal your wine, giving yourself another 3 days, assuming that you have stored this properly away from the sunlight, right? So that will give you more bang for your buck when it comes to your wine.